goodness, oh my goodness, now they're fighting. Oh, okay, no, sleep. Oh my goodness, oh my goodness.
I found all of y'all. Go back to sleep.
It's my mama, Annie. She was riding on the ferry boat, and she was holding me up to see all the big ships. And then I couldn't find her no more.
Well, it was only a dream, honey. You've got to go back to sleep. It's after 3 o'clock.
Annie, we fear now.
Again.
Please.
Sure, Mommy.
Here it comes again.
Please take good care of our little darling.
She was born on October 28th. We'll come back to get her soon.
We left half of the silver locket around her neck and kept the other half.
So that when we come back for her, you'll know that she's our baby.
Oh my goodness, now they're laughing.
All right, do you want to sleep with your teeth inside your mouth or out?
Gee, I dream of having a mother and father again, but you're lucky you really got them.
I know, somewhere.
Turn
you say?
I love you, Miss Hannigan.
Rotten orphan.
I'm not an orphan. My mother and father left a note saying that they love me and they're coming back for me.
Well, that was 1922 and this is 1933. So for this one, shenanigans, you'll all get down on your knobby little knees and clean this dump till it shines like the top of the Chrysler Building.
But it's 4 o'clock in the morning.
Well, you better get to work.
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Why any kid would want to be an orphan, I'll never know.
In the laundry bag.
Bundle? Oh, wait!
kid you donated an apple to the orphans picnic?
Well, I'm not known by them anyway.
Gee, thanks, mister.
Say, kid, what did you have in this picnic?
Soon as I take a bite.
Have you seen any stray kids around here?
No, sir.
Good, they must be running wild in our classroom.
Hey, there's one they didn't get. They're after you, ain't they? Well, they're after me, too. But don't worry. I ain't gonna let them get you or me. Everything's gonna be fine. For the both of us. If not today, well, the sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow.
Weather.
Oh, I don't mind the weather.
Drawn by me. career.
So no bubbles, I think.
A net comes in to make your bed.
Still, no, Sanchita.
I think I'm gonna like it here.
When you wake, bring for drink. Tray will bring a tray. When you're through, Mrs. Mew wants to take it away. No need to pick up any toys.
That's okay, I haven't gotten any anyway.
No finger will you lift, my dear. We have but one request. Please put us to the test.
I know I'm gonna like it here. Used to
took 11 hours. Grace?
Yes, sir.
Messages?
President Roosevelt wants you to call him at the White House.
Oh, I'll get back to him tomorrow.
Mr. Warbucks?
Oh, yes. Good to see you all again. Drake?
Yes, sir.
Dismiss the staff. Now, Grace, if you'll get your notebook in. Who is that?
This is Annie, Mr. Warbucks, the orphan that'll be with us for Christmas.
That's not a boy. Orphans are boys.
I'm sorry, sir. You just said orphan, so I chose a girl.
Well, I'll suppose she'll have to do. Annie, huh? Annie what?
Oh, I'm just Annie, Mr. Warbucks. Sir, I haven't got any last name. I'm sorry I'm not a boy.
Oh, not at all. I couldn't be happier. Grace, we'll start on the iron ore figures from Toledo to... What are we supposed to do with this child?
It's her first night here, sir.
Well, Annie, I suppose we ought to do something special on your first night. Would you like to go to a movie?
Gosh, Mr. Warbucks, I've never been to one.
Then you'll go to the Roxy, and an ice cream soda at Rumpelmeyer's, and a handsome cab ride around Central Park.
Golly.
Grace, forget about the dictation for tonight. Instead, you'll take Annie to the movies.
Yes, sir.
Aw, gee.
What's wrong, Annie?
Well, I thought you were going to take me.
Oh, I'm afraid I'll be far too busy tonight. You see, I've just been away 6 weeks, and when a man is running a multi-billion dollar corporation...
Oh, sure. I know. That's okay, Mr. Warbucks.
Drake.
Yes, sir?
Get our coats.
Oh, gee!
Grace, you'll come too, of course.
Which car will you be watching, sir?
The Duesenberg. No, wait. This child has been cooped up in an orphanage. We'll walk.
Walk to the Roxy?
Why not? It's only 45 blocks.
Yes, sir.
Ah, smell those bus fumes. There's no air like the air of New York. Come on, you slowpokes. We gotta get to the Roxy before the prices change.
NYC, the shimmer of Times Square, the pulse,
the beat,
the drive. NYC, you might say that I'm square, but wow, I've come alive.
The city's bright as a penny arcade, shimmering sin, tilts and rings. Little brat. It ain't fair, this here life is dry. instead of less. Maybe we fix the game with something shady. Give me a one guess. Yes!
Your money, but I'm telling you, you've got to do something. Listen, we'll talk about it all on
Friday.
Listen, Mr. President, why don't you come here with Mrs. Roosevelt, supper Christmas Eve, and we'll bury the hatchet. You will? Wonderful. Goodbye, Mr. President. Grace, find out what Democrats eat.
Yes, sir.
The package from Tiffany?
Arrived this morning.
Fine. I'm going to give it to her and then tell her I want to adopt her.
She's
going to
be the happiest little girl in the world.
Get her down here.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Annie, can we have a man-to-man talk?
You're sending me back to the orphanage, right?
Oh, of course not. Annie, I was born into a very poor family, and both of my parents died before I was 10. So I made a promise to myself. Someday I was going to be rich, very rich.
That was a good idea.
But lately, I've realized something. Even if you've got all the money in the world, if you've got no one in your life to share it with, if you're all alone, then you might as well be broke. I was in Tiffany the other day, and I picked this up for you.
For me? Gee, thanks, Mr. Warbuck. Gee.
It's a silver locket, Annie. I saw that old broken one you always wear, and I said to myself, I'm going to give that kid a nice new locket. We'll just take the old one off and...
No! I don't want a new one.
What's wrong, Annie?
This locket. My mom and dad left it when they left me at the orphanage. And the note, too. They're coming back for me, and I know I'm real lucky being here with you for Christmas. But the one thing I want in all the world is to find my mother and father and to be like other kids with folks of my own.
It'll be all right. I can help. I'll find your parents for you.
Mr. Warbuck will find your mother and father even if he has to put everyone in his organization on the job. Even if he has to pull every political string there is to pull.
Up to and including the White House. Annie, give me your locket.
For Mr. Warbuck.
I understand, but it could be our best clue. We'll have the FBI trace it and find out who bought it.
Okay, then maybe they should have my note too.
Just you wait, you may be meeting your mother and father within a couple of days.
Really?
Really.
Oh boy, I gotta write a letter to the kids about this.
Nothing to occur, finding them, losing her. Oh, you won't be an orphan for long.
And pretty soon, everyone will know I'm looking for my folks, because we're getting around the radio. And tell them, so make sure you listen, okay? So...
stop by?
Good evening, Bertie Lee. It's nice to be here.
So I understand that you have something to tell folks about at home about little Annie here.
Yes, Bertie Lee. I am now conducting a nationwide coast-to-coast search for Annie's parents. Furthermore, I'm offering a certified check for $50,000 to any persons who can prove they're Annie's parents.
Leaping lizards!
So, Annie's parents, if you're listening in, write to Oliver Warbucks, care of this station. Thank you, Oliver Warbucks.
Thank you, Bertie Lee.
I see by the old clock on the wall that another of our Thursday night get-togethers has gone by faster than you can say oxygen. Yes, this is your old softie, Mrs. Healy's boy, Bert, saying, until next week, same time, same station. Good night.
Gee, Annie on the radio? Coast to coast. She's famous!
Wish I was on the radio.
Me too. Who wants to be on the dumb old radio?
I do.
So for all the apple smiles here, this is Bert here to say.
Easy Street.
sorry, Andy. I've spoken to more than 1,000 people claiming to be your parents, but they were all liars and fakes.
Are you certain?
Yes, sir. None of them knew about the locket. I'm so sorry.
That's okay. You did your best. Anyway, I guess we can get along without folks. You didn't turn out so bad.
Grace, do you have those legal papers I gave you the other day?
Yes, sir. Right here.
Annie, I want to adopt you.
Adopt me?
Yes or no?
If I can't have my real mother and father, there's no one in the world I'd rather have your father than you, Mr. Warbucks.
Annie, this isn't just going to be an adoption. It's going to be a celebration. And you can have anyone in the world you'd like to come to it. Well, who will it be?
I guess I'd like Cheryl here, and Mr. Drake, and Mrs. Pugh, and well, everybody here.
Drake.
Yes, sir?
Tell the staff to get spiffed up. They're all going to be guests at Annie's adoption party.
Yes, sir!
Oh, and the kids.
Oh, I'm afraid it'll be far past their bedtime now. But I'll tell you what. We can have everyone from the orphanage here tomorrow for a big Christmas party.
Miss Hannigan too?
Why not? Annie, I'm the luckiest man in the world.
And I'm the luckiest kid. Together at last. Together forever. We're tied in a knot.
Need sunshine now to turn my skies to blue.
I don't need anything but you. Yesterday was plain awful.
You can say that again.
Yesterday was plain awful.
But that's
not now, that's then. I'm poor as a mouse.
I'm richer than mice.
Shirley, look, there's Aunt Annie.
Who are you?
Honey, where are your mom and dad?
We've seen a great number of people.
Well, here's Annie's birth certificate and our driver's licenses.
Baby girl named Anne Elizabeth Mudge, born to Relevant Shirley Mudge, New York, New York, October
28th, 1922. October
28th,
that's my birthday.
Ralph, look. Annie's wearing the locket.
Yes, when we left Annie at the orphanage, we left half of the silver locket down and kept the other half. That way, she knows that she's our baby.
Yes, it fits perfectly.
Thank God, Ralph, she's our Annie.
Mr. Mudge, what about the money?
Well, we ain't got much, but we'd be glad to give you whatever.
You haven't heard? I've offered a certified check for $50,000 to anyone who can prove they're Annie's parents.
No, sir. Anyway, we don't want no money.
On the other hand, Ralph, remember that little pig farm out in New Jersey? $50,000 we could afford to bring Annie up right in the country.
Oh, of course.
Would it be all right if Annie stayed here with us until tomorrow morning, Christmas? Then you could come back and pick her up and the check.
Whatever you prefer, sir.
Bye, Annie, love. Oops.
Pardon me, Bonnie. Merry Christmas.
Well, this is
wonderful news.
Drake Champagne.
Yes, sir.
We must celebrate because the most wonderful thing that could have happened has just happened. Annie has found her parents, and I propose a toast. Hey. To Annie Mudge.
To Annie Mudge. Annie!
I've lost Annie.
Sir, I have the strangest feeling that I've seen that Mr. Mudge before, and he's not who he says he is.
Then I won't give her up till we're certain.
But how?
I'll find a way. I'll go straight to the top, the President of the United States, even if he is a Democrat. FBI men coming and going. Annie, did you know the President is here?
Really?
Mr. President.
Merry Christmas, President Roosevelt.
Merry Christmas, Annie. Annie, early this morning, FBI Director Hoover telephoned me with some very sad news. Is it seen in the identity of your parents?
Yes, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
No, dear. Aiden and Margaret Bennett.
Annie, your parents passed away a long time ago.
You mean I'm an orphan after all?
Are you all right, Annie?
Yes, because I know they love me, and they would have come for me if they weren't.
I love you, Annie Bennett.
I love you too. Now, who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
Well, the birth certificate could easily have been forged, but nobody knew about the letter except us.
Well, and the FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan!
Miss Hannigan and the children from the orphanage.
Hi, kids!
Hi, Annie!
Ah, Miss Hannigan, delighted to meet you.
You too, Mr. Warbucks. I know you anywhere else.
Hey, kids, look! There's presents for all of us!
This just come from the FBI.
Now it all fits together.
Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
Good morning.
Merry Christmas, one and all.
Well, we don't want to bother you on Christmas, though. We've just come to pick up a check.
Ah, yes. A check.
$15,000 certified. Pay to the old room. The jig is up.
Yes, the jig is up, Daniel Francis Hannigan, also known as...
Rooster Hannigan, also known as Ralph Mudge, also known as Danny the Dick.
Let's turn them over. Yes, sir.
And I believe you'll find that this woman is their accomplice.
Annie, tell them how good and nice they was to you. Oh, gee, I'm sorry, Miss Hannigan, but remember the one thing you always taught me, never tell a lie. Miss Hannigan's gone for good.
Yay!
And you won't have to work anymore.
Yay!
A new
So do I, Franklin. A new deal.